is good. Welcome back to your new video, you beautiful bastards. We are going to give you 3 tips on how to gain weight as a hard gainer. There's usually 2 people when it comes to the gym. There's the red pill and the blue pill. On this side, there's people that are trying to lose weight, and then there's people that are trying to gain weight. And we're trying to gain some fucking weight, baby. We're trying to put on some size. So I'm gonna run you through it. I'm a hard gainer myself. Here's a, I'll send you a picture of like me being like this little skinny twerp. Boom. That's what your boy looked like. 0 genetics. I mean, like most people, you can even see their before pictures, like people who look great now. And you're like, oh, they had like cap delts. You can like kind of see their abs. Yeah. Can't see shit on mine. So I got y'all with the hard gainer tips, but I am also gonna show you guys at the very end of the video my 1300 calorie shake. So I know y'all motherfuckers will be dripping for that, okay? You hard gainers that want every calorie under the sun, y'all gonna fuck with it. It tastes great too. But yeah, we're gonna get ready for the gym and I'ma just run you through some tips as we go along with our day. A lot of people ask like what my goals are with the maxes. I want a 365 bench, a 500 squat, and a 675 deadlift by my 22nd birthday. So how many months is that? August 6th is my birthday. It's just 8, isn't it?
Yeah,
January, February, so. March, April, May, June, July, August. Yeah, 8 months. I can do that shit.
Easy.
I can do that shit easy. I'm probably gonna do way more than it. I think I might do more on bench because I already got like 335 in me on bench. So 365 is like what I gain 5 pounds and sleep real good for 3 months. I'll invite Lex for a 405, but I should copy his shit. Bring David for my 675 deadlift.
Wait, he flew David out there?
I don't know. David just be doing Dave. Whenever I call David, he's just fucking, he's the coolest dude ever. We called him. I was on FaceTime with Lex and we called David and he's sitting like this, like his old aesthetic videos, like when he was flexing the webcam, he was like this and he looked up at us. He had like a separate FaceTime.
That's so funny.
And he was like this, leaned back, just showing his shreds. He's like, what's up, guys? Just fucking David laying in the chair. We're just like, what are you doing? He's like editing some shit I'm never gonna post. Oh, babe, do you wanna show them the Christmas tree?
Yeah. Okay.
Anyways, look, this is the best ornament though. Shout out my boy Gravy. He passed this along to me. So like my rave folk, y'all know that shit a big deal. Wait. He like put on my neck and everything. He was like, he did the ritual. Like, you know the rave? They do the bracelet, they're like, and they roll it under their shits.
Yeah, I didn't know about that until I went to the Get Freaky and then some chicks did it. And
it like means a lot too.
I was like, what the fuck are you doing?
They're like giving, they're like spiritually giving a part of them to you.
Yeah.
And you're just like, I don't want the fucking bracelet.
Dude, I just had no idea because some chick like grabbed my fucking hand and then like put it on. I was like, what are you doing?
Is that like rave assault?
Bro, I don't like, I've done all that shit.
You got my baby.
That's what we like to see.
Yeah.
5 years later.
So, for my car peeps out there, the turbo went out on the Supra like 4 months ago. Has it been like four months? I haven't driven the Supra in like 4 months. No turbos were in stock anywhere. So we were looking for like trusted sources for even used turbos. We were that desperate. My tuner, Colorado N5X, he has like connections and stuff. And we were like going through trusted sources. We got screwed over by some dude who like let us on like a whole month. And so we were just sitting around waiting. Shout out Pure Turbos for sending me this. They came in clutch. I've been waiting for too long without my baby. So we finally got her. Our tuner said minimum low 700s. On the horsepower. So
wait, so when are you gonna put that in?
I'm gonna schedule with Envision. So shout out Envision. They're gonna be working on the GTI. We're gonna wrap it and everything. So fast Supra and running Supra very soon.
So
I'm gonna PP and then we're gonna make some pre. I'm definitely going cherry blackout. I have not taken cherry blackout in a minute. Uno scoopo, 2 scoops for the full serving. And then I'm gonna throw beta alanine in it. Boop, boop. Y'all already know, code monkey to save on Gorilla Mind supplements. Helomix water bottles. We got bench today. I believe we got triples. I think it's like four sets of three. So I'm probably going to go like 275 or something because it's RPE. Let me check. Sitting at RP 7. People are still asking about what RPE means. Rate of perceived exertion. How many reps do you have left in the tank out of 10? So I have 7. So essentially I got 3 reps left in the tank every set. RP 8, you got 2. RP 9, you're going heavy and you only got 1 left. Okay? Understand? All right. Let's start with the first tip on how to gain weight as a hard gainer. Okay? So, I have noticed that people that are trying to gain weight, that are hard gainers, are not eating enough, and they're eating a lot less than, like, y'all think you are. When I was first trying to gain weight, too, I was going through the same thing. I'm like, bro, I'm shoveling food. I'm always full. Why am I not gaining weight? The scale is not moving up anymore. Trust me, bro, you are probably not eating enough, and if you are eating enough, the scale will move up. I promise you. So, my tip for you guys is to take what you eat in a normal day, just track it, just eat like normally how you would, and just throw it into MyFitnessPal, track it. And then at the end of the day, that'll give you a good indicator of the amount of calories that you're eating. Chances are that if the scale is not moving, you're not eating enough and the calories will reflect it. Try that out, track your calories for a day and then adjust from there. If you tracked your calories and you were eating like 2,500 calories, like after eating normally throughout the day, you can increase your calories like 300 to 500 and then just go from there. Be consistent, you will plateau. I plateau usually like every couple months or so, like once a month, every couple months. It's a lot longer of a period for you plateau than it is when you're cutting. I've been sticking with like 4,500 calories now. The weight is still moving consistently, so nothing to fix. But once my weight plateaus, I'll take it up like 300-ish calories just to get the weight moving again. But eat more, okay? Y'all motherfuckers not eating enough.
More.
Talking of more. Yeah, y'all motherfuckers talking about, I can't gain this weight. I'm eating everything under the sun. And it's not. You're just eating shit that makes you full, and you're eating it less often. So you're just getting full 3 times a day. You're only eating like breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That is not enough calories. If you're a hard gainer, I'm sorry. We got it harder. That's why it's called hard gainers, okay? But hard gainers are usually leaner individuals. So like David Lade, Lex, those people can like eat 5,000 calories and still stay lean year round. So consider yourself blessed in that aspect, but eat more, motherfucker. Say no more. I'm gonna finish my pre. We're gonna bust out this bench day. Bro. Wait, have you tried them? These are good. I was confused when I got the Apple headphones and people were like, bro, you gotta try the Skull Crushers. I'm like, dude, they're like half the price. There's no way they're better than them.
Yeah.
And I tried them because when we went to XL or something, I think I left them.
Yeah.
And then I just never found them again. Someone needed Apple headphones more than me. So I got some Skull Crushers. These are fucking amazing. I think they're like 180 bucks. Or something.
Oh, damn.
It's like way cheaper than Apple. Look at the padding. Look at that Tempur-Pedic ass padding. Jeez. I'm doing a fucking ad for Skull Candy. I'm not even sponsored. But yeah, these are kick ass. You guys were right. I'll admit it. You guys are fucking right. Dude, try them.
Yeah.
Let me see your reaction. Shaking my hand. Bro, it feels like I had 2 subs on me. 10 out of 10 review.
It's like hit my fucking G spot on my head. All right. So, dropping the weight down to 225, we're gonna run some closed grip touch and go bench press. I've been doing a lot more closed grip stuff. Even on my other days, I'll do like closed grip Spodo press. That's where you pause it like a couple inches off your chest when you do it. I don't stray too far off of
bench itself, like, you know how people use like bands and chains and shit. Honestly, you want a bigger bench, just get better at benching. Increase your benching. I bench like 3 times a week. I know some people that bench even like 4. So obviously you bring overall volume down on like your accessories and stuff. Like I'll max do like a cable chest fly or like a dumbbell press after benching. I don't be doing like a full chest workout. So bench more, do a little less chest work, but getting better at movements in general is gonna set you up for success when it comes to strength, okay? So we're gonna run like, I think it's a 3x6 at like RP 6 to 7-ish, so going kinda light, but we're just gonna bust these out. So, next tip for you guys. Pre-planning your day of eating helps so much, bruh. So, you don't even have to eat the same thing every day. I'm not saying you gotta meal prep 4,000 calories a day or anything to gain weight. Go into your MyFitnessPal or whatever app you track your food with. That's just the one that I track with. Schedule what you're gonna eat for the day, so you know that if you eat everything on that list that you're gonna hit your calories. If I was having a beef and rice and potato meal or something along that nature, I can match the calories if I went to like Chick-fil-A with my friends or some shit. Doesn't matter, just pre-plan it, you'll be better off, and then you're not scrambling for calories at the end of the night like a little dumbass, okay? I've been adding in a little bit more chest work, just like a couple of extra sets of isolation, and chest is like one of my biggest weak points. Get my titty game up, okay? It's like pretty intuitive, but I'm doing like around like 3 sets of anywhere from like 10 to 12. Just getting a good squeeze and contraction for the titties. Last movement, we're gonna bust out some tricep extensions. I like to just rock with the easy bar. It's a little more natural than a straight bar. I feel like with a straight bar, it kind of restricts just your joints in general. I feel like having a curve in the bar, even right here, the starting position with a straight bar, there's like no tension on your tricep. So when you start with something that's like more curved and it fits your wrist joint, then you get a better contraction. Yeah. I like doing like either this curved bar or like the long rope. The long rope feels good too. You get a good stretch and contraction. I feel like the straight bar just like kind of restricts your wrist joint connecting to your elbow, because you want everything linear, you want everything aligned. All right. Boys and girls, so we are back in the kitchen. I'm gonna show you how to make my 1300 calorie shake. But firstly, we need to talk about calories. So when you're trying to gain weight, especially as a hard gainer, this is tip number 3, you need to focus on eating caloric dense foods only. okay? If you are a true hard gainer and you gotta eat like tons of calories, you need focus on the foods that got the most calories. I'll just name some sources with protein, carbs, and fats, for instance, just so you guys can kind of get a better idea of which foods you can select to gain some weight. Protein, for instance, you wanna go with things like eggs, whole milk, red meats, like fattier beef trims. Salmon is a good one. And for carbs, you can do more whole grains. You can do pasta, bagels. I even rock with cereal in the morning sometimes because that has a lot of calories paired with whole milk. And then fats, you got like avocados, full fat yogurt. You can even count that as a fat. Peanut butter. Peanut butter is your best friend while you're bulking. But for my boys that can't eat a lot of food, this should help you. My 1300 calorie shake, I used to make it in high school before I went to school, and then I would eat like two school lunches, and then I was going ham on the calories. So first up, milk, lots of calories. Blueberries for some flavor. A lot of people don't know that Gorilla got protein. Chocolate peanut butter is the best flavor. It tastes exactly like Reese's. Trust me on that. I like to throw two bananas in there. They're usually frozen. I let them defrost a little bit. It tastes great. And then you can stick with any peanut butter, whatever you like. Get your notepads ready. We're gonna go over the serving sizes. 20 ounces of milk, 100 grams of blueberries, 100 grams of oats, 2 scoops of protein, 2 bananas, and 64 grams of peanut butter. Looks like a ball sack. And then the nanners. You would think like all 1300 calories is probably shoving calories in there and it tastes like shit. This shit tastes good. I'd be sipping on it. Good old Quaker Oats. Slap this bad boy on. And then you just open this bad boy and just sip on it. But yeah, the 1300 calorie shake, you can drink it like in the morning if you go to the gym later, or I more so like to drink it like post-workout now. I probably wouldn't drink it directly pre-gym. I used to do that before, and sometimes I would shart my pants a little bit. It's a lot of calories and it's like a lot of milk and stuff, so you might get the poopers a little bit, but it's 1300 calories. If you cannot physically chew like enough food to hit your calories, this is a good last resort. Hopefully those tips help you hard gainers out and just people bulking in general. Let me know how the shake tastes. Just DM me on Instagram or some. I know you're gonna fucking love it. And good luck on your bulking endeavors. But that is going to be a wrap for the video. So, if you did enjoy, slap that like button in the ass, okay? Until next time, peace out, baby.